It's that time again. Most satisfying sound in the world, by the way. It wasn't as great as it could have been. Wouldn't put that in a Coke commercial. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we are listening to a viewer's request. This is the Dukes of Stratosphear with the song 25 O'Clock. This is a request by Halicon. So, Halicon, thank you so much for the request. I have no idea what this is. The Dukes of Stratosphear were an English rock band formed in 1984. Their genres are psychedelic pop and psychedelic rock. They are apparently an offshoot of the band XTC, another band who I have not heard of. How different will this sound compared to their normal stuff? I don't know, because I haven't heard their normal stuff. My exposure to them is going to be this song, 25 O'Clock. And perfect timing, because at least at the time of this recording, tomorrow, we'll have to set the times back. Even though you don't really have to do that anymore, everything's done on your phone. So people always ask me, like, you know, when is it? Or, you know, what exact time are we supposed to set it back? I have no idea. I just let my phone do all that work now. Anyways, it's Saturday. I hope that you guys are having a great Saturday, even though it's probably not Saturday at this time. But regardless, I hope you guys are having a great day. I know that so far I am. I don't have much to say. Let's just go right into the song. Thank you guys so much for watching. Halicon, thank you for the recommendation. You guys can join me on Twitter. You guys can join me in the comments down below. I'm going to sip on my ginger beer a little bit. And this is 25 O'Clock by the Dukes of Stratosphear.
Apart just adding to my power. Each
really like that ending. I like how they ended that. Dun, da 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 dun, da da da. That was cool. That was cool. Throughout the song, I was getting reminders of, like, the Rolling Stones. I don't know why. It kind of sounded like Painted Black. That was very reminiscent of, like, older psychedelic and psychedelic pop and that kind of sound. I can definitely hear remnants of that in here. Actually, the whole thing sounds like it. And even going as far as the production side, it has that same kind of roomy, slightly echoey, slightly distorted production that you would get from those bands of those at that time. But it seemed that there were little things to move that production up a little front. For example, with the bass and how it was just driving the whole song. The way that the organ or the keyboards came in. I really like how the keyboards came in throughout the song. It says that Dave Gregory was on the Mellotron piano, organ, and guitar. And I think that's what it was. It was a Mellotron that was being used there. I love the sound. I love that sound of the Mellotron. When Genesis uses it, sounds great. When Opeth uses it, sounds great. It's just one of those sounds that I enjoy and I like listening to. And it works perfectly here because it adds this beautiful yet slightly uneasy feeling to the song. Which, looking at the cover, listening to the music, and listening and reading the lyrics, it kind of has that throughout the whole thing. It is this dreamy, surrealistic landscape that they're creating with their music, but there's also something a little bit off about it, which is also shown to us by the title, 25 o'clock. Obviously, there's not 25 hours, so the 25th hour doesn't exist. Or maybe it exists in their drug-induced mind. I don't know. Get the clock sound effects, sure. But I do like how it just gets right into it. I like that section there, and I like the way it opens, because it begins at a certain pace. You get the clock sound effects, and they ring, alarms going off. Then the countdown begins, 5. Right? You would expect 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, at least I would. But then the tempo changes, the voice distorts, everything changes in that little moment, and then we get into the actual tempo and rhythm of the song. So I like how time itself is not only a theme musically for them, but they're really taking that theme and, like, shaping their song according to it. And I like how in the background of the song, you can hear the Mellotron and the keyboards along with the guitar, just providing this nice subtlety in the background. I really like it because the guitar it's distorted and it's just a little bit under in the production. It's in the back there, but it's adding this subtle layer. And then the few times that the vocalist more yells his vocals, it works very well because through the verse, it's very dreamy. It's uneasy, but it's dreamy. And just like those alarms you heard in the beginning of the song, it's like he's waking you up out of this dream. Like something's not right. Lyrics. The urge to take you grows more strong. For time had made me wait too long. Each watch I smash apart, just adding to my power. Each watch I smash apart, just bringing near the hour. And then at the beginning he said time. So the urge to take time grows stronger. Time is something that's always against us, but specifically against him. Of 25 o'clock, that's when you're going to be mine. 25 o'clock, we'll be together till the end of time. At 25 o'clock. Well, 25 o'clock, like I said earlier, doesn't exist. So he has this hopelessness of being together with this person. It may not be romantically, it could just be some sort of connection. But that's not going to happen because he's just never going to get to that point. Almost like he's trying to stop time from continuing so that it can have this person with him. Whether it's a good way or a bad way, I'm leaning towards the bad. At 25 o'clock, that's when you're going to be mine. 25 o'clock, we'll be together till the end of time. At 25 o'clock, that's when you're going to be mine. Till the end of time, till the end, till the end of time. And then he screams time at the end. Basically sounds to me like time is just against this guy. He wants to be with this person, whether for good reasons or for bad. Not considering the effects, or not really considering that he really can't. You can't stop time. This is also the opener from their EP. Overall, this wasn't particularly a song that I liked. It wasn't bad, just nothing really stood out to me or caught my attention. So I can say that I probably won't listen to this again. But as always, I appreciate the recommendations. I'm open to listen to anything. I'm open to be here, to try things, but not everything that's gonna stick. This. We'll be right back. Like, I like it. It definitely has some bounce to it, and it definitely has some good stuff in it. Just overall, it's not really a style that I'm particularly drawn to, if I'm being honest. But Halicon, seriously, thank you for the recommendation. I always appreciate them. You guys, you can join me in the comments down below. You can join me on Twitter if you want. And I'll see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.